Though I have covered this topic before on YouTube, I have decided to update and refine my arguments. For one, it's not just the act of having abortion itself, but we need to look at the very mindset of abortion. And yet now in some states, do you even realize that a mother can decide to kill her baby after it has been born? This is a real stronghold in our society today, and I believe it needs to be challenged. Jesus said, for example, not only not to commit adultery or murder, but out of the heart is where it proceeds the evil thoughts, such as lust and anger, which are the root causes of both. Many of us today are appalled by the inhuman way the Nazis treated the Jews. They're starved to death, tortured, and were operated on as if they were play toys. Even in this country, blacks in the past were not only slaves, but tortured and endured untold grief and pain at one time. Yet the key to remember, it begins with the way a person thinks. Even for pro-choice, at one time, it was the norm to say that once a baby was born, they're safe and deserve our protection, and they have a right to life. But this is no longer the case in some states, and that thinking has become more mainstream today. Second, consider the research of stem cells has led, to my opinion, to the harvest of the unborn just as spare parts. To the Christians, I would remind you that evolution has been a factor to the mindset of abortion, because Darwin himself considered blacks as subhuman. And to those that believe in macroevolution, my question would be, at what point did man evolve in which an eternal soul could exist? To those that respond and say, well, there's no eternal soul, then at what point is there value in human life? If you respond by having a consciousness, well, how did you come to that conclusion? Second, if one believes in an eternal God and God knows everything past, present, and future, then why would he use evolution to create mankind in his image? Because he would know how to do it right the first time without the millions of years of trial and error and needless suffering. Remember, God is believed to have all knowledge past, present, and future. But I believe at the heart of the matter is the very mindset of abortion that does not value the eternal soul. For if it did, they would not consider an abortion as a mere medical procedure like getting your tooth pulled, but a sin against an eternal God. As a believer, I believe we should be able to defend our faith, which includes a defense of the unborn. Not only is abortion a stronghold of society, but instead of focusing the eternal value of all women, including those that are not able to even get pregnant, their value is that of the eternal nature given by the Creator. Instead of focusing on this power over the helpless, this so-called right is the stronghold, I believe, that imprisons society today to accept such genocide. What was considered off limits 50 years ago now has been endorsed by some states. Like I said, that even a baby is born can be killed if the mother so desires. Finally, not only in the natural, but God has a place of destiny for each believer. Yet at times, we may abort the very thing that God desires to accomplish in us, and thus we might actually allow the very mindset of abortion to influence us in such a way as to disrupt and abort the very purpose of God. You know, there was a video I saw some years ago in which a lady was near an abortion clinic, and she was confronted. Someone said, well, do you believe abortion is murder? She said, yeah. He then asked, well, do you think it should be illegal? She said, yes. Then he said, well, then what should be the punishment for the woman that is having an abortion since you believe that it's murder? At that point, she had this deer in the headlight look. But folks, that doesn't change the fact whether it's right or wrong. And in a future episode, I will give my answer concerning that. So I hope you stay tuned, because the next couple episodes, I want to really deal with some of the major trick questions and objections that the pro-choice people use. especially my body, it's my right, or it's the fetus a person. I will also have another video on the so-called support for abortion. And finally, what does the Bible really say concerning the topic? Is it really silent? Which it's not. So I hope you stay tuned and be ready to free your mind.